Here. Shake hands with danger.
Shake hands with danger. Need a guy who ought to know. I used to laugh at safety. Now they call me Three Finger Joe. Any shortcut, and you're inviting injury. In this absent-minded state, he unconsciously starts to steer, jams his foot on the differential lock, and the machine takes off. Lucky for the stunned operator, the machine stops itself. Glenn knows the risk of striking hard against badly chipped metal, but he's wearing safety glasses, and there's a macho thing involved here. Glenn doesn't want his friend to sneer at him for being overly cautious. So, Glenn shakes hands with danger. If Glenn had insisted upon playing it safe. Some old-timers think accidents happen only to greenhorns.
Hey, Red, I got a bracket on. You want to come take a look at it?
Let them learn the hard way, they say. Now, let them learn the hard way can be an attitude that results in serious injury.
Ouch!
Sorry about that.
He gets by with it on that longer piece. Shake hands with danger, step right up and say hello. Grinding wheels and metal are what made Three Finger Joe. With both tracks removed, the machine is free to roll. On a slight grade, it may just take off. Despite constant warnings about hot oil and pressure systems, some optimist always thinks he can get his hand away in time.
Somebody help me.
Needn't have happened. At this point, the service manuals called for the insertion of a threaded tool to hold the spring force. Sam hasn't read the manual. He doesn't know he's releasing a force that might be as high as 1,750 pounds. Warnings about gasoline are as old as use of the fuel. Yet somewhere, somebody is always deciding it won't hurt to use it as a cleaning fluid just this one time. Oh, he'll empty the pan very carefully, just as soon as he finds a rag to wipe off the carburetor. Meanwhile, the fuel keeps vaporizing.
Over there,
and I ought to
be done in a minute.
It's possible. possible to become overconfident about handling dangerous materials. A good reason why safety instructions should be repeated at frequent intervals. This is the moment, that split second when a man decides between being safe or shaking hands with danger. A stick or a swab, Bill could have had the linking members moved apart and greased them separately. It would have been a nuisance, but Bill Myers would give anything to be able to go back and do it the right way. Both push arms, and he should never have relied upon anything as unstable or crushable as building blocks.
What's the matter up there? Get this machine out of there!
Now, Bob isn't dumb. He wouldn't try towing it all the way to the shop without help, but he just wants to drag it 100 yards or so and get that foreman off his back.